Hey guys!
Hi guys!
So it's that time of year again. So new Funko Pop fans out there that aren't familiar with it, once a year in July and June, because June can count, Funko comes out with San Diego Comic-Con Funko Pops. They're exclusive usually, in a way.
Right. I mean, they're sort of, exclusive. I mean, it just depends on the notoriety of the pop.
Yeah. So. But the gist of it is, some of them are really hard to get, so, you know, we'll go over that later as the time goes and then the month goes. You'll see it on the Facebook and everything. It's just really hard sometimes to get these pops. You got to be, like,
clicking warriors. You have to be, on your computer ready to, like, just fight people ferociously through the keypad.
Yeah. But what Funko does before San Diego Comic-Con, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, they did this last year, they announce a few of their exclusives, basically.
Yeah, and it's so exciting when they start doing this because we get all these leaks and it builds up all this excitement and anticipation.
Right into Comic-Con.
Oh my god, yes! And then you, like, fight people, throw bows, I mean,
and only get, like, two or three the ones you wanted, so that's just how it works.
And then you find out, oh hey, that one was, like, back-ordered, you're not getting it.
that's true. Or you paid a lot of money for one and then it comes later to somewhere else.
Yeah,
that's
for, like,
easy
10
to get.
Bucks. And you're like, oh, well, that sucks.
That's true. So, we did this last year. We're going to do it again. We're going to go over the first day of San Diego Comic-Con 2015
Yay!
Funko Pop release, whatever. I don't know. Let's do it. So the first one that we saw was Goldbender. What did you think about Goldbender?
I think it looks pretty cool. I'm excited. I wonder if it's going to look like some of the Star Wars pops, how they are really metallic and shiny. So I'm not...
It's hard to say, you know? Gold is strange when Funko paints things because sometimes it's really shiny and crazy looking, like the Amazon exclusive SpongeBob. That thing was super gold. And then you have other gold ones like this that it looks sort of like a tan gold or something. I don't know.
It's kind of... Yeah, but I think it's going to be kind of cool. I'm sure
the C-3PO gold chrome looks like the coolest chrome in my opinion.
Futurama fans are going to be happy.
Futurama fans, I think it's cool. I think you'll like it.
Yeah.
Definitely a good, like, ode to Bender.
Yeah, definitely.
So up next, we have the Doctor Who fans are in the house now. So we know Doctor Who pops are out there, which is, like, a huge set. I would say that and Harry Potter are probably the two biggest series to come out this year that are just going to swarm people that aren't regularly Funko Pop fans. They're going to think, whoa, this is crazy.
I
love Funko.
I cannot wait to see when the Harry Potter pops start, like, people start getting these that aren't normally Pop fans, and they're just going to be like, oh my god, these things are great. They're going to fall in love, and I'm excited.
Harry
for this.
Potter fans, I think Funko Pops in general are perfect for them.
Oh, for,
like,
sure.
They can really transition well into that, I believe. So,
I mean, as a Harry Potter fan myself, we like to collect wands and pretty much everything you can imagine from Harry Potter. So,
theme parks, butterbeer, whatever it is.
Fire whiskey. Boy.
So, what we saw was the 12th Doctor in his space suit. Was this enough of an exclusive for Doctor Who fans to be happy?
I'm not sure. Maybe not. I guess it just depends on how hardcore of a Doctor Who fan you are. If you're just kind of like a casual watcher, it's not really that big of a deal.
Yeah, I think if you're like a hardcore Doctor Who fan, I think this one you're going to like because it's fun. But,
yeah, I mean, it's
but as something, you know, I just think they could have maybe just had something crazy. And this is only the first day. They don't.
Oh, for sure.
The good stuff always comes a little later,
honestly. The first
day
last year, we were kind of like, meh. And then the second day, we were like, whoa. Oh my God. So, and you have days where it's just like, this is kind of meh, and days where it's just like, this is
awesome.
Best. So,
but I know this is cool, and I think Doctor Who exclusives are really where you need to be at, and I think Harry Potter is where you need to be at.
Oh, man.
There's a lot of these
series.
If
they come out with Harry Potter exclusives, I will fight for those.
Well, I think it's a good time to talk about a leak right now, since we're already into it with Harry Potter. There was leaked information about a Hogwarts Express coming out. Maybe it was for EB Games, so maybe it's GameStop in America, who knows.
Well, that means I won't get it.
And then, well, maybe. And then we also heard that Sorting Hat might be coming out, which is going to possibly be a Barnes & Noble exclusive.
I have to have the Sorting Hat. If I don't get that, I'm going to be highly PO'd. So.
It'd be kind of strange just to get a hat inside of a box. Is that weird?
No, not at all. He talks. He has a personality.
That's true, I guess.
Come on now. I'm sure he's going to have face.
That's true.
It's
we need Hedwig,
great.
Though. I think Hedwig needs to come out.
We
it needs to be flocked.
Need
a flocked
Hedwig.
Hedwig would be so sick.
Oh, my God. I would have to have, like,
but we don't get that. But we won't get that yet because he's not even a character yet. But if he came out, or whatever. Sorry, guys. Sorry, Harry Potter fans. But if she came out, I think, you know, we'd have the regular version, but I think a flocked would be a perfect exclusive.
I think definitely a flocked would be an amazing exclusive. One that I would have to have. Oh, my God.
Okay, up next, we have one that's a little So it's sadness, and it's from Pixar's Inside Out, which looks awesome. Like, I cannot wait to watch the movie.
Too. I think the show looks so great, and I love, like, anger. I just love that little character. He's always
They're saying the show is going to be, like, one of the best Pixar movies in a long time. So I'm really excited.
Really?
Yeah, a lot of people are saying it's, like, the best one in a long time, and maybe the best story Pixar has ever come up with. And that's, like, going against Toy Story, which is, like, one of the best.
That's
like,
going to be pretty hard to beat.
Yeah, so I can't wait to see it, but, So, sadness. Now, I don't know much about her character, but I do know the show all has to do with emotions, you know, so
sadness. She looks so sad!
But in this exclusive, I think it seems that she has glitter hair. That's the exclusive.
Maybe her body is glitter. No, her face isn't.
Her hair.
Yeah.
It's just glittered hair as an exclusive.
Maybe it's something that she does special in the movie that we don't know about yet. Maybe when she gets really sad, she cries glitter from her hair or something. I don't know.
Dang. Oh, maybe. I don't know.
Wouldn't that be weird?
But from an outside perspective of not really knowing much about the character, I think this is just not that good. You know, it's just straight up not good enough. So.
Whatever.
Up next, we have one that I'm kind of excited about because I don't have this yet. I don't have the Deadpool Chimichanga van yet. I plan on getting it, but then I saw this one, which is the X-Force Deadpool Chimichanga van, which I don't even know if that exists in real life. But
question, do you want both or just one?
If I was going to have one, I feel like this one's cool. Like,
this
for me,
because
it's just different, you know, and I like different things, you know. But the Chimichanga van in itself looks awesome, you know, the yellow and how sharp it is. So I don't know. I'll probably end up having them both. That's just my life.
I like this pop. I love the gray van because the colors just pop off of it and they just look like they're jumping out.
Yeah, those peppers and everything. Yeah. I like this. I think this is cool. I think this is a good idea. I think if you're a super Deadpool fan, it's a must-have. I think everybody else, it's just cool.
Yeah, I think so, too. I don't think this is going to be one where it's going to sell out and people are going like, oh my god, I didn't get it. I think it's going to be one you're going to be able to find.
I think it's going to sell straight out.
You think so?
I don't know, though, because pop rides just, they don't.
That's why I don't think it's going to sell that
well. That's true, but we don't, have you ever had an exclusive pop ride besides Toy Tokyo's Batmobiles?
No, and those went crazy fast.
They went crazy fast.
But they were Batman. Yeah,
that's true. Up next, we've seen in the past these vinyl idol dolls or whatever you want to call them. They're like animation rubberized like figures, which is really cool. I mean, they look like they're straight off the stop motion floor. Like,
they really do.
It's pretty amazing. Like, they're actually really awesome. They're about $20 a piece. It looks like
which isn't too bad.
So you know, for something that looks just like really good, like you know, when you buy those like Coraline little action figures or whatever, those things were super expensive, and they're like the same kind of motif a little bit worse, you know, in that way, but. I think these things just blow my mind because I don't know if exclusives of this will sell well.
I don't know if they'll sell that well because I haven't seen very many of them in the stores. So I don't know.
I don't know if any are out yet.
Maybe not. So we don't know. They might do really well.
This one's Dr. Venkman and he has slime on him. Now, if you'll notice, the exclusivity to this one is only 500 pieces. So, I think Funko is being smart on this one where they've decided to, you know, test the waters first.
Going back to the original exclusivity of Comic-Con, like, my...
480 piece.
Yeah. Wicked Witch one. Whatever, so... Yeah. I mean,
Which would be impossible. If you came out with a 500-piece Comic-Con exclusive,
There would be no way you'd be able to get it online. You'd only be able to get it at the con.
$500 right away.
Right. It'd just be crazy. Which would break my heart, so...
So, yeah, I don't know about... These vinyl idols are very, very cool.
They're cute.
So it's going to be interesting just to see what's going to happen with these, you know? Yeah. So it's there, you know, take a look at it. Now, this is what's interesting to me. So last year and the years prior, Pops were really Funko's main, like,
That was their bread and butter.
Yeah, it's like everything was pop. But now, and a few like very limited Hikaris, but Hikari just wasn't anything that was exciting to a lot of people.
Yeah. Well, now especially because of the price too.
Yeah, the price is expensive, but now you've seen these premium Hikaris coming out, and they're just like wickedly awesome.
They're so cool.
I mean, it's just unbelievable, like what paint jobs and things like that Funko's doing to these things. And now we got to see the first Hikari seen to come on 2015, and it's an infrared Boba Fett, and it looks awesome.
I think his suit looks so good. It's so shiny. I think all Star Wars fans are going to like fight for this because it looks so good.
Yeah, that metallic red.
Oh my god. Oh, man, it's like a candy apple red. It's so pretty. So
I think Star Wars fans and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle fans, and even My Little Pony fans, I think this Hikari line is really right up your alley, because I'm telling you, these things look a lot better when you see them in person. I know online they look a little strange, like, they're like, eh, what's the big deal? But I'm telling you, when they're in the box and they're on the shelf, it's like, those things are really
nice. We thought the same thing. We're both kind of like, I don't know. And then we went into Barnes & Noble and he saw one of the Ninja Turtles. He's like, I have to have them all.
They're pretty cool.
They're pretty amazing.
They're just awesome. I mean, just in general. Yeah. Finally, to bring up the rear, is a Dorb. So we know Dorbs. We've seen them. They're small little figures. Matter of fact, here's a Dorb that we got in the Marvel Collector Core box of Ultron. So they're little small guys, right? Well, what's interesting about this one is it's a 6-inch Dorb. So they're already getting into the big Dorbs. Like, boom, here we go.
Big Dorbs. You're a big Dorbs.
Yeah. I think it's interesting to, how well will a 6-inch Dorb do?
I don't know, because they're kind of top heavy, so it'll be interesting to see how it sets, but...
Does that...
It's like competing with Pops, so...
It's just a little strange to me, because... Now, don't get me wrong, I want this. This is super, like, on my list, because I'm a huge 66 Batman fan. The thing is, though, these things are adorable, because they're small and cutesy, right?
Yeah, they're like little itty-bitty purse size.
But if they're 6-inch, does that ruin it?
Kinda.
I don't know. It's going to be interesting. I think it's cool, though, because it's big, but it's not overly big, and it might look really good. I think this is the type of thing you might get, like, one or two of. I'm just not really sure about the Dorbs XL.
I think he's cute. I'm not quite sure how well it's going to do, like you said. I don't know. The Dorbs, I'm not a huge fan of them yet. I've only seen one or two of them, so I still have to be won over.
I got a lot of them on pre-order because I think... They're kind of awesome in a way. DC DC ones are really cool to me.
I didn't even know you had them on pre-order.
Yeah, I gotta have the OG ones. You know, they got the Penguin and the Harley Quinn and the Batman and Robin.
Yeah, I guess I have to have Harley Quinn.
I gotta have all those. And the reason I had to have those is because the Disney Vinylmations don't have DC. You know, Marvel and Disney, they're like this, you know. So I don't know if they're ever gonna have DC versions of them.
They probably won't.
You know, so I figure, hey, this is the second best thing.
Get them,
you know, they're only gonna get them. So and I don't have to have the Mickey Mouse ears on, which is kind of cool.
Yeah, that's true.
But you know, they're both cool. So I like the Adorbs, and I'm just gonna keep calling them Adorbs because you know why call them Dorbs? You might as well call them Adorbs, right?
Adorbs.
So I think this is cool. This is one on my list. This is probably the. I don't want to say the only one, but maybe this is the only one for day one that I am specifically interested in. I think that this 1966 6-inch Dorbs, that's so weird because it's like Dorbs. Do you call it a Dorb? Do you call it Dorbs? Do you call it a Dorbs? How do you say this? So
the struggle is real.
The struggle is real, man. The life of a toy collector, geez. So, yeah, so I think that the 66 one is the one that I want most out of this list.
Yeah,
so.
I agree. I think that's about the only one today that I'm like, I have to have. I don't know, though. We'll have to wait and see what else is released because there might be,
Wednesday.
Like, other stuff that comes out that I'm like, I don't really care for that. I'd rather have the Chimichanga Mobile, so.
That's right. Chimichanga Mobile is pretty cool, so. All right, guys. We will see you Wednesday
see you
with
Wednesday.
Another video. So, hoping for good stuff.
That's right.
See ya.
Bye, guys.
Bye.